the infinite darkness of the universe, there exist objects so powerful that they can bend space and time itself. They are invisible, yet their immense force shapes galaxies, influences stars, and consumes everything that gets too close. This is Flight into a Black Hole. Prepare for a fascinating journey into a world where Earth's physics ceases to function, where time and space switch roles. All videos from the This Is series are available ad-free now on my Patreon, Paul Black, Paul Black. If you're interested in the topics on my channel, start following me for more content. Now sit back and relax, we're starting. A black hole is an extremely dense object with gravity so strong that not even light can escape. When we look at any other cosmic object, planets, stars, or neutron stars, we see that their gravity depends on mass and size. The heavier and smaller the object, the stronger its gravity. But a black hole takes this to the extreme. It is a point of infinite density where the very laws of physics as we know them break down. The boundary of a black hole, known as the event horizon, is the point of no return. Anything crossing this limit, light, matter, even time itself, can never escape. It falls toward the singularity, a point of infinite density that, according to general relativity, crushes everything into an unknown form. Because black holes emit no light, we cannot directly see them. Instead, we detect them by their gravitational influence on surrounding matter and the way they bend space-time. The physics inside remains a mystery. Scientists believe that the fundamental forces we understand, gravity, electromagnetism, and even the concept of solid and liquid matter, may no longer function as they do on Earth. On Earth, we perceive space as a vast, mostly flat expanse in which we can move freely. Time flows steadily, always in one direction, at a constant rate. If you were to approach a black hole, time would continue to pass normally for you. But to an external observer, you would appear to slow down, fading into a frozen moment before vanishing completely. Once you cross the event horizon, something extreme happens. Time and space swap roles. You are no longer moving forward in space. Every direction you could travel now leads only deeper into the black hole, toward the singularity. Everything that falls in, light, matter, entire stars, spirals toward an unknown fate. Because the singularity is a point without volume, the depth of a black hole is theoretically infinite. Black holes challenge our fundamental understanding of space and time, and no one truly knows what lies beyond the event horizon, because no one has ever returned. If you cross the event horizon, the black hole might appear to stretch out before you, like a tunnel into infinite darkness. Some theories suggest that the interior of a black hole is not static, or that it may lead to an entirely different part of reality. Could it be a gateway to another universe? The answer remains unknown. Falling into a black hole is often compared to a whirlpool. Once you're caught, there's no way out. But in reality, it works a little differently. Matter doesn't just fall straight in, like a rock into a well. Instead, it usually orbits the black hole first, spiraling inward in a glowing disk of superheated gas and dust, known as the accretion disk. This swirling motion is due to the law of conservation of angular momentum. Objects rarely fall directly, but instead circle around before being pulled in. A key difference between the whirlpool and the black hole, however, is that a black hole has no solid surface. There is no physical hole to fall into. Once something crosses the event horizon, it is as if it vanishes from our universe. We can never see it again, and we have no way of knowing what happens beyond. If you had infinitely precise instruments and watched an object falling into a black hole, you would observe several distinct phases. At first, the object would fall at a normal speed, approaching the black hole. Its motion would appear natural, similar to how things fall on Earth. As the object gets close to the event horizon, gravitational time dilation begins to take effect. This means the time for the falling object flows differently than for you, watching from a distance. From your perspective, the object slows down. The closer it gets to the horizon, the slower it appears to move. Once the object reaches the event horizon, its motion would appear extremely slow, almost as if it had stopped. Additionally, its light would begin to shift toward longer wavelengths due to gravitational redshift. This means its color would shift from its original hue to increasingly deeper shades of red, eventually moving into the infrared, microwave, and radio wave spectrum. To the human eye, it would become invisible. Even if you had infinitely perfect instruments, eventually, the object would emit such long wavelengths that it would become practically impossible to detect. To you, it would seem as if it never truly vanished. It would still appear to hover just above the event horizon, becoming dimmer and dimmer until it was no longer visible. However, you would never actually see it cross the threshold and disappear inside. So where does it go? There are two perspectives on reality that attempt to answer this question. You, observing from a safe distance, have infinite time. The object dims until eventually no more light is emitted. However, technically speaking, it remains frozen just above the event horizon. If you were the one falling, you wouldn't experience any slowing down. From your perspective, you would cross the event horizon normally, within seconds or minutes, depending on the black hole's size. If the black hole is not particularly large, the immense tidal forces would stretch you out to an extreme degree. This process is known as spaghettification. Tidal forces, which are responsible for Earth's ocean tides, would be so intense inside the black hole that they would tear any object apart down to its atomic components before it ever reached the center. However, if the black hole were supermassive, such as the one at the center of our galaxy, an object could theoretically cross the event horizon without being immediately destroyed. It would continue to fall toward the singularity, where reality behaves according to completely unknown physical laws. This leads to what physicists call the black hole information paradox. Some theories suggest that instead of collapsing into an infinitely small point, a black hole might give rise to a completely different form of existence, one we can't yet describe or understand. It could, for instance, take the form of an extremely dense quantum foam. This idea was proposed in 1955 by American physicist John Wheeler, who suggested that miniature wormholes and bubbles could form briefly in what is known as space-time, a four-dimensional construct that merges length, width, height, and time into a single entity. In 1974, Stephen Hawking published a paper in Nature titled Black Hole Explosions, in which he proposed that black holes are not entirely black, but instead emit faint thermal radiation, now known as Hawking radiation. One theory suggests that matter doesn't simply vanish in the singularity, but instead emerges somewhere else in the universe. This ties into the hypothesis that black holes could serve as gateways to other regions or even other universes. Imagine the universe as a sheet of paper. Normally, we would travel from one point to another along the surface. A wormhole, however, would fold the paper, creating a shortcut between two distant locations. This means you could enter a black hole in one part of the universe and instantly emerge somewhere else. While there is no direct evidence that such wormholes exist, mathematical models suggest that they are possible, and the equations of general relativity do not rule them out. Black holes form through several processes, but the most common scenario involves the death of a massive star. When a star several times the mass of the Sun exhausts its fuel, its core collapses under its own gravity. This usually results in a supernova explosion, which expels the star's outer layers into space. If the core is heavy enough, its own gravity will compress it so intensely that it collapses into a point of infinite density, a black hole. Black holes do not have fixed locations. They move through space just like stars and galaxies. If they form from a collapsing star, their motion depends on the velocity of the original star. Supermassive black holes, however, are typically found at the centers of galaxies, where they remain relatively stable due to the immense gravitational influence of the galaxy itself. Smaller and even supermassive black holes can also be ejected from galaxies, drifting alone through the cosmos. A black hole itself has no color because it does not emit light. However, its surroundings can display a range of colors, from red to blue to white, depending on the accretion disk, redshift effects, and high-energy jets of matter and radiation. These jets, moving at nearly the speed of light, are expelled by supermassive black holes, neutron stars, and quasars. Black holes themselves do not have a surface that reflects light. They are transparent, but not in a way that allows us to see through them. Instead, all we see in their direction is a dark, empty void in the fabric of space. The light from distant stars and galaxies bends around them due to a phenomenon called gravitational lensing, creating what is known as an Einstein ring. At first glance, it might seem strange that we call it a hole, when in reality, a black hole looks more like a sphere. The term hole refers to the disappearance of any object that crosses into it, vanishing without a trace, as if falling into a bottomless pit. What we actually see from the outside is the event horizon. From a distance, this appears as a dark sphere or circle, often surrounded by a glowing ring of light, known as the accretion disk. This is a swirling disk of gas, dust, and stars spiraling toward the black hole. Friction between particles heats the matter to extreme temperatures, causing it to glow across different wavelengths, from visible light to X-rays. It might sometimes seem that multiple accretion disks exist, but gravity tends to organize matter into a single flat disk. The universe is not entirely chaotic. Gravity constantly works to arrange matter into stable structures. Any rotating matter naturally flattens into a single dominant disk around a black hole, just as the planets in our solar system are mostly aligned in a single plane due to angular momentum. Collisions between particles help unify the disk. If more than one disk formed with different axes of rotation, their particles would begin to collide and rub against each other. This would gradually align their motion, ultimately stabilizing into a single plane. A black hole pulls in matter from different directions, but eventually, all incoming matter merges with the dominant disk. Any secondary disk would be gravitationally unstable, either merging with the primary one or being torn apart and ejected. In extreme cases, a black hole might have multiple layers within its accretion disk. However, this does not mean separate disks like Saturn's rings. Some supermassive black holes can have complex disk structures due to intense radiation and turbulence, where matter accumulates in both inner and outer regions, yet still remains part of a single connected system. A temporary secondary disk might form when two black holes merge, one being a stable stellar-type black hole, while the other forms from the gravitational collapse of a star. The incoming matter could briefly create a transitional disk. Imagine you decide to orbit a black hole. How long would it take? That depends on two main factors: the mass of the black hole and how close you choose to fly. At a great distance, gravity has less influence, and the orbit could take hours, days, or even weeks, similar to how planets orbit their stars. Around a black hole with 10 times the mass of the Sun, a full orbit might take just a few seconds. For a supermassive black hole, it could take hours. If you approach the event horizon, time itself starts behaving strangely. To you, everything would feel normal, but an observer watching from a safe distance would see you slow down. This is due to extreme space-time curvature. Gravity slows the flow of time. The closer you get to the black hole, the stronger the effect. Now, imagine returning to the observer after orbiting the black hole. While your journey might feel like only a few hours or days, for the observer, years, decades, or even centuries could have passed. This means that when you return, the world as you knew it might be long gone. Your observer might have aged significantly or no longer exist, while you would have experienced time almost normally. This phenomenon is called gravitational time dilation. The effect is so extreme that, in theory, you could use a close orbit around a black hole as a kind of time machine into the future. Simply fly close enough, and then return. Thousands of years might pass in the rest of the universe while only hours pass for you. You can test gravitational time dilation even here on Earth. Take two identical wristwatches and synchronize them. Leave one on the ground and place the other on a high mountain. After some time, you'll find that the watch at the higher altitude runs slightly ahead of the one on the ground because it is farther from Earth's gravity. The same principle applies to GPS satellites. Their onboard clocks run 38 microseconds faster per day than clocks on Earth. Even a tiny difference of 1 microsecond could cause a navigation error of up to 300 meters. What theories about black holes fascinate you the most? Would you ever want to know what lies beyond the event horizon? Or do you have your own theory? Share your thoughts in the comments. If you enjoyed this video, I'd really appreciate a like, sharing it with others, and subscribing to my channel. You can find more videos from the This Is series ad-free on my Patreon. Some episodes are also on my YouTube in this playlist. And don't forget to check out the slow walk videos with chill out music.